This is the week to make sure there's not something a little extra in your guacamole.
Well, Matt, at the risk of getting hungry for Mexican food, I understand that you have a story about guacamole.
I do have a story about guacamole. So this is specific to Apache Guacamole, which is actually a remote access setup from the Apache Foundation. So Checkpoint's security researchers just released a report saying that they found some critical vulnerabilities in Apache Guacamole that not only allow you to attack the guacamole server, but also attack people who connect to it, which is pretty interesting. They're calling these like reverse RDP vulnerabilities based on some earlier research they've done into RDP. So Guacamole lets you do things like VNC RDP SSH through like a friendly web interface in HTML5. So you don't have to install thick clients. It's very nice to be able to just jump onto a box remotely that way. And I've used it in the past, and it is a cool tool. Unfortunately, these bugs exist. Some of them are in free RDP, which I think is a component, or somehow tied to Apache Guacamole. So they're able to do a couple different things with it. But ultimately, the good thing here is that these bugs were found back in May and patched silently for some of the older versions. And the final version of Guacamole has these completely fixed. So if you are at the latest version of Apache Guacamole, you are set. Otherwise, it is time for you to go and look at what version you've got and make sure you get patched. But there are patches.
So Matt, I mean, does that mean that they have to patch both the client and the server?
So for most people, the client is just a web browser, and I don't think they need to have to patch it. But when you start talking about these sorts of gateway things, client and server get a little bit muddled. But ultimately, I hope I can answer it by saying you can take over a machine that's behind Apache Guacamole, something you're trying to remote into, and then from that compromised machine, compromise the Guacamole framework and then get the keys you need to jump into all the other boxes that are behind it. So like if you compromise one guacamole machine, you can compromise all of the other ones. Hope that helps.
Yeah, I'm just thinking of the whole consequences just seem kind of scary. I mean, like you said, it's patched, but it just seems scary. You think about here's your whole VPN infrastructure that could allow somebody to kind of backdoor into it.
Mm-hmm. I wouldn't exactly call it VPN because it's not really a tunneling protocol so much as it's more like it's kind of like Citrix, where you have like a master jump box through which you can access the desktops of a whole bunch of other machines.
Got
it. Right, and then if you compromise that, you can basically act as a middleman, right?
Right. Not necessarily for men in the middle, but at least you gain access to a bunch of other machines that you generally wouldn't have access to. Like if someone's, for example, set up a cluster of like each person has a machine behind Guacamole and you log in as Manish and you get to access Manish's machine, with the bug, you get to access everybody's machine.
Understood.
And it's a set of bugs. So it's very detailed. I actually recommend everyone read the whole article. Because there's a lot of details in there that I'm glossing over here.
If I remember too, a lot of this, like I said, is patched, but like a lot of Guacamole stuff has kind of gotten a lot of interest just because of all the remote desktop due to the COVID pandemic.
Sure. There are more users doing it. And honestly, it's being treated kind of like a package in certain other remote access systems. Like someone else will include it. It's the same kind of thing as having any one of those older. Like if you have a bug in libc, right, you know, you can patch libc, but if it's not replaced everywhere it's being used, you still have a problem. It's kind of like that, except this is much, you know, it's a different kind of package, but it's still a component that people may or may not realize they're using as part of something else that they're using in their company.
I said, it's just scary. That's the only thing I keep thinking of. It always makes me nervous.
Especially now where, you know, there's probably a lot of companies that, you know, needed to set up some infrastructure for allowing their employees to access what they needed because they can't get into the office, and they may have just rushed into deploying this and not really configured it correctly, haven't patched it, and probably aren't even sure how it fully works.
Well, that sounds like the same old story. But yeah.